Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our morning prayer. This morning, the 24th of April, just to say for our members, this morning, I will be conducting the funeral of the husband of our sister Charity. So do keep Charity and the family in your prayers. In your prayers this morning, as we say farewell to Sarfo Manu, her husband, this morning. And so let's get started. morning prayer. So let's pray. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. In your resurrection, O Christ, let heaven and earth rejoice. Alleluia. Blessed are you, Lord God of our salvation. To you be praise and glory forever. As once you ransomed your people from Egypt and led them to freedom in the promised land, so now you have delivered us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of your risen Son. May we, the first fruits of your new creation, rejoice in this new day you have made and praise you for your mighty acts. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. Amen. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us, so let us celebrate the feast. Not with the old leaven of corruption and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Christ, once raised from the dead, dies no more. Death has no more dominion over him. In dying, he died to sin once for all. In living, he lives to God. See yourselves, therefore, as dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who sleep. For as by man came death, by man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. The night is past, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. And the psalm this morning is Psalm 61. Psalm 61, and I will do as I've done, is read the psalm, and then I'll read the commentary devotion from Tim Keller's book. Psalm 61. Hear my crying, O God, and listen to my prayer. From the end of the earth, I call to you with fainting heart. O set me on the rock that is higher than I. For you are my refuge, a strong tower against the enemy. Let me dwell in your tent forever, and take refuge under the cover of your wings. For you, O God, will hear my vows. You will grant the request of those who fear your name. You will add length of days to the life of the king, for his years may endure throughout all generations. May he sit enthroned before God forever. May steadfast love and truth watch over him. So will I always sing praise to your name, and day by day fulfill my vows. Amen. And Psalm 61 commentary from Tim Keller. Psalm 61 is about protection. Psalm 61 is about protection. David piles up images. God is his rock, a secure place where he can see things from God's perspective. God is his fortified tower, where he can take refuge from attackers. God dwells in the tabernacle, where he can be met in worship. God is like a mother bird, protecting her chicks under her wings. Jesus claims each of them for himself. He is the temple, John chapter 2, verse 12 to 21, where we can come face to face with God. He is a mother bird, protecting his loved ones by sheltering them and enduring danger and pain while keeping them unharmed. Luke 13. He is the rock, 1 Corinthians 10, verse 4. Struck for us. So in Jesus, we are kept safe from every enemy, even, and I would say, especially death. So the prayer, Lord, I praise you that I am truly, only, and finally safe in you. You are sovereignly working all things out for your glory and my good. You have removed my sin in Christ, so my ultimate future is bliss. You hear my prayers and you care for me. I thank you for being the rock that is higher than me. Amen. There's just one other thing I would love to point out from this psalm. The psalmist prays for the king, for the life of the king, which is a reminder to us that we are to pray for our leaders and those who are set in authority over us. In the New Testament, Paul tells us this in Timothy, that we are to pray for the king and those in authority. And so here we have an example in the psalm where he's asking for the life of the king to be extended, especially if it's a good king, someone who's righteous and does the will of God. All right, the reading, the New Testament reading. The New Testament reading is, we're back into Colossians this morning. Yesterday we moved away a bit, but we're back this morning. And it's Colossians chapter 3. Colossians chapter 3. From verse 12 to chapter 4 and verse 1. Colossians chapter 3 and verse 12 to chapter 4 and verse 1. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you were called to peace. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly as you teach and admonish one another with psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. With gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Wives, submit to your husbands as is fitting in the Lord. Husbands, love your wives and do not be harsh with them. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this pleases the Lord. Fathers, do not embitter your children, or they will become discouraged. Slaves, obey your earthly masters in everything, and do it not only when their eye is on you and to win their favor, but with sincerity of heart and reverence for the Lord. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for human beings. Since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward, it is the Lord Christ you are serving. Anyone who does wrong will be repaid for his wrong, and there is no favoritism. Masters, provide your slaves with what is right and fair, because you know that you also have a master in heaven. Amen. So this is God's word. And as I've done, just to point out, pick out a few things here. If you notice the first verses 12 to 14, Paul says we are God's chosen people. We are holy and loved. And so because we are God's chosen people, we are to put on a certain clothing. We are to wear a certain spiritual clothing. Clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, and above all, love. You see, because we are chosen by God, because we are God's chosen people, we are to wear these virtues like a garment, like we wear our clothes, so that others will see our compassion, our kindness, our humility, our gentleness, our patience, and our love. And of course, he says, bear with each other, forgive whatever grievances you may have against each other, forgive as the Lord has forgiven you. So there we have it. That's the foundation of our Christian conduct. We are to show humility and patience. And then verse 15, let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts and be thankful. You see, have that peace and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Let Christ's word live in you. Last night, we're talking about Christ abiding in us. Now, Paul says, let the word of Christ dwell in you, live in you. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God the Father through him. And then later on in verse 23, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord, not for human beings. You see, these are the principles. We are the Christian motivation for doing anything that's good is in Christ Jesus. We are doing it for Christ, in Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit. We're not doing things for ourselves. We are working for the benefit of Christ. We are working to please Christ. In all that we do, we are seeking to please Jesus. So in all our conducts, in all our attitude, in all our behavior, in all our words, we are to show humility, compassion, love, generosity, gentleness, patience, and forgiveness. And we are to do this with all our hearts. Not half-hearted, but with all our hearts. And then, of course, as Paul does and all the New Testament writers does this. They give you practical ways in which you can do this. So husbands, wives, children, slaves, masters, live like this, basically. This is how you're to live in the family. This is how you're to live in the workplace. Slaves and masters. That's the workplace. This is how you are to live with one another, to show these qualities, these characteristics of being a Christian. So, wives, submit to your husbands. Husbands, love your wives. Children, obey your parents. Fathers, don't discourage your children. Slaves, obey your masters. Masters, be fair to your slaves. See, all of this, Christian people are to exemplify Christian principles in their lives as we live it. So let's pray. Let's pray. Oh Lord, we thank you for this new day. We thank you, Lord, for your goodness and mercy to us another day. We come, Lord, with all that's on our hearts. We come with our own anxieties, fears, cares, worries, concerns. We bring them to you this morning. And Lord, we know because you've told us to come with all our cares, with all our anxieties, because you care for us. Like a mother hen protects her children, you protect us. You, Lord, watch over us. And you show us that you care by dying for us on the cross, Lord Jesus. And so we come. We bring our own hearts to you. We bring our family to you. We bring our church family to you. Wherever our people are this morning, we bring them to you. We ask, Lord, that you'll be with each of us. Be with all of us. Whatever we are doing today, whether we are shut in or whether we are working, Lord, we pray that you will be with all your people this day. Watch over us in all that we do. Keep us safe from the enemy. And we entrust our day to you. We entrust our church to you and all our people. We pray, Lord, for those who are sick. Lord, you know them by name. You know their ailments. You know what they're going through more than we do. Lord, you know them. All those that are on the prayer list in our own church, we pray for them this morning. We ask that you will remember them in your mercy. Those who are bereaved, we pray especially for Charity and the family this morning as we gather to say farewell to Sappho. We pray, Lord, that you will be with the family and give them some peace and comfort in this service this morning, we pray. And Lord, we just lift up all those to you who are sick, and especially, Lord, those who are suffering from the coronavirus. We pray for them. Lord, we ask for your mercy and compassion upon them. We pray for the doctors and nurses and the carers and all those on the front line looking after those suffering from this disease. We pray that you will give them wisdom, give them strength, protect them from virus, protect them, oh God, from any form of infection. And so, dear God, we pray for ourselves this morning, even as we read your word, we pray that you will help us to clothe ourselves, put on humility and gentleness and patience and love, Lord, and forgive. Help us, Lord, to live like this so that, Lord Jesus, you told us that the world will believe when they see what we are like as imitators of Jesus Christ. And so, Lord, help us to do what we do for you, for your glory, and for your honor, Lord Jesus. May we work at whatever we are doing with all our heart, because we are working for you. And we know that we have a reward that far surpasses any reward that we could possibly get in this life. And so, Lord, remind us, O God, of this truth today as we go. As we meditate on this scripture today, fill us with your Holy Spirit and empower us to live for you. to be more like Jesus in our actions, in our thoughts, in our words. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. And so let's say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against you. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Amen. And so we listen to the song that I've been playing, In Christ Alone. So may the Lord be with you today and give you his grace to live for him, to please Christ in your life. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Have a blessed day.